The Theory of Political Economy by William Stanley Jevons. Chapter 4. Theory of Exchange. Part 16. Competition in Exchange. One case of the theory of exchange is of considerable importance and arises when two parties compete together in supplying a third party with a certain commodity. Thus, suppose that A, with the quantity of one commodity denoted by A, purchases another kind of commodity both from B and from C, who respectively possess B and C of it. All the quantities concerned are as follows. A gives X1 of A to B and X2 to C. B gives Y1 of B to A. C gives Y2 of C to A. As each commodity may be supposed to be perfectly homogeneous, the ratio of exchange must be the same in one case as in the other, so that we have one equation thus furnished, y1 over x1 equals y2 over x2. Now, provided that A gets the right commodity in the proper quantity, he does not care whence it comes, so that we need not, in his equation, distinguish the source or destination of the quantities. He simply gives x1 plus x2 and receives in exchange y1 plus y2. Observing then that y1 plus y2 over x1 plus x2 equals y1 over x1. We have the usual equation of exchange. Phi1 a minus x1 minus x2 over psi1 y1 plus y2 equals y1 over x1. But B and C must both be separately satisfied with their shares in the transaction. Thus, phi2 x1 over psi2 b minus y1 equals y1 over x1. And phi3 x2 over psi3 c minus y2 equals y2 over x2. There are altogether four unknown quantities, x1, x2, y1, y2, and we have four equations by which to determine them. Various suppositions might be made as to the comparative magnitudes of the quantities b and c, or the character of the functions concerned, and the conclusions could then be drawn as to the effect upon the trade. The general result would be that the smaller holder must more or less conform to the prices of the larger holder.